Thank you, Bethany. Good morning. It's great to be with you all today. This is my third year as chair of Westminster's Stewardship Committee. It's also the third year that my request for a raise has been denied. But that's something I'll take up with session later. During the time that I've held this position, I found the job to be challenging, hence the request for a raise, but also surprisingly rewarding. In fact, if I'm honest, it's been deeply rewarding and convicting. Little sidebar. If you want to really feel part of an organization, a church, team, volunteer for a job that requires you to dig in, to serve, to work closely with others, and to learn how the organization operates from the inside. The payoff is rich. And this brings me to two experiences I've had during this year's pledge drive that really have made an impression on me. They happened when I and a few members of the stewardship committee were handing out packets in the narthex. You saw us the first 3 weeks of the campaign. And this first experience had to do with an exchange I had with another member who also serves on a committee. And I've gotten to know this person because we've been in meetings together. And when he came by the table to pick up his packet, he leaned in and he said quietly, "You know, this year, I'm gonna up my pledge a lot." He said, "Once you learn what goes on behind the scenes here and you realize how much it takes for Westminster to provide all it needs, you think to yourself, I've gotta give more, and that's what I'm gonna do." As you can imagine, I didn't respond with, "Now look, you might wanna take some time to think about this." Said I was very grateful. And then I also questioned whether I was getting it. So that's where the convicting part comes in. The second time I was deeply impressed by an exchange with a member occurred when I stopped this person in the narthex as she was leaving, and I wanted to thank her for her early pledge. It meant a lot, and I'm trying to do that more when I think about it. And I expected to hear something such as, "Oh, sure, you're welcome. I'm glad to give." But instead, the response I got was almost one of surprise. She stopped, she paused, and she looked at me and she said, "I love this church." As if to say, of course that's why, you know, I'm giving, and you don't need to thank me. Again, I was grateful, but I asked myself whether I had given enough to a church that I truly love too. This is the fifth week of our annual campaign. And for the previous four, you heard other members complete the phrase, "Westminster is," which was this year's campaign theme. They talked about Westminster being community and worship, education and service, all things that come to mind when we think of Westminster. This week, though, I want you to think about how Westminster is stewardship, which is the careful and responsible management of something entrusted to one's care. If you call Westminster your church, and you love it, and you want to see it continue to grow and thrive, and to be here when you need it, then I ask you prayerfully to consider pledging so that you too are responsible for its management and care. Last thing, if you look closely in the narthex at the thermometer visual, you'll notice that it doesn't feature a goal of dollars raised. Rather, it shows how many Westminster households have pledged. And the stewardship committee made a conscious decision to do that because we want the emphasis to be on participation and not how much you give. To date, the mercury has risen to 30%, which is really good. It's the best it's been in a while. And if you've already pledged, thank you so much. If you haven't, even if you give only a small amount, it will matter and it will be treasured. Look at it this way. If you're a member here, you're part of a family. And family members need to take care of their own as best they can. So together, let's move that mercury